Last week you heard about Elvis Presley, who changed rock and roll in the 1950s. Today we're going to talk about the 60s. And you can't think about the 60s without thinking about the Beatles. Now I don't mean the insects, that's spelled B-E-E-T-L-E-S. I'm thinking of the rock band, B-E-A-T-L-E-S. Get it? Beat? Beatles? Well, in 1960, that started a new decade, and a totally new and unexpected revolution in pop music came from England. Who were the Beatles? Well, they were four guys from the poor working class of Liverpool, England. At first, they wore jeans and leather jackets and got a lot of practice with concerts in Germany. But things changed when they came to America. They were influenced by Elvis and wrote more than 200 songs and created their own unique sound. They were John Lennon on rhythm guitar, Paul McCartney on bass guitar, George Harrison on lead guitar, and Ringo Starr on drums. Well, to show you how big they were, their first album stayed at number one on the charts for 30 weeks. That's a long time. Very successful. In order to get noticed in music, you've got to do something different than the people before you. I mean, if I wrote an Elvis song, people might say, "Sounds great, we've already heard it." So the Beatles created original sounds through their catchy melodies and harmony. They made up chord changes that were different from what other bands of the day used. George Harrison loved the culture and place of India and started playing the sitar. Nobody had used the sitar in American rock and roll before, and if you'd like to hear that, it's most prominent in a song called Norwegian Wood. In the army and wore a closely shaved crew cut, while the Beatles wore shaggy bangs. Their hairstyle was slightly longer than was traditional for men at that time, and that became a symbol of freedom and was copied by young people everywhere. A lot of teenagers' parents listened to Elvis, or perhaps were in the aftermath of World War II with that military look. And now the hippies were taken over. People went crazy for the Beatles. It even got a name, Beatlemania. Girls fainting, waiting in line for hours, crying. Well, of those four Beatles, Lennon and McCartney were a very strong songwriting duo. One source says they wrote 193 songs. They include Obla-dee, obla-da, life goes on, brah. Or, I wanna hold your hand. And, all you need is love. Bum, bum, ba, ba, bum. You say it's your birthday. Na, 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 na. Blackbird singing in the dead of night. Take these broken wings and learn to fly. Can't buy me love, can't buy me love. Too many to name right here, but those are some of them. Well, the Beatles took a risk coming to America because British bands had never been popular in America before. Boy, did the Beatles change that. People went so crazy on the Beatles' first trip to America that in 1964, there were 4,000 fans waving goodbye to their airplane in England and 3,000 American fans waiting when they arrived. After landing and getting in the limousine, Paul turned on the radio, and I've heard him tell a story in an interview that the announcer on the radio was saying, they've just turned left. They are headed north on 93rd Street, things like that. And Paul thought, what's going on? He's talking about us. So the Beatles had never been to America unfamous because that first trip to America, Beatlemania exploded. They were not expecting this reaction. Who could? And they were overwhelmed. They were famous. On that trip, they appeared on a television show called The Ed Sullivan Show. And I'll show you a picture of that. It's a very classic Beatles look. Paul McCartney is a unique guitar player. He plays left-handed. So you've got the guitar of his neck facing one direction, two other guitar necks facing the opposite direction, and Ringo has a very simple drum set. Today, our drum sets can almost form a full circle for those professionals. They have stools that swivel and they could travel between bass drums and tons of cymbals. Well, Ringo was the opposite. One bass drum, one floor tom. You'll see that classic, polished, tight look. Slick, that's the word I'm looking for. The Beatles were nicknamed the Fab Four and they immediately rose to the top of the pop charts. One of them even had a fever during that Ed Sullivan sound check. And someone stood in for him, and John Lennon said he was so nervous he wrote the lyrics on his hand. Well, the Beatles also starred in two successful movies, showing how bands started to use different modes of entertainment to entertain their fan base. Sometimes so many people were screaming at the Beatles concerts that they couldn't even hear their own music. And in 1966, they decided to take a break from touring. They went back into the studio and created some sounds that are more geared for the studio, new production techniques and an orchestra. The Beatles recorded an album called Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. Whoa, that's kind of a long title. And it was released in the summer of 1967. I'll show you a picture of the very arty cover. It features over 75 faces. Lots of faces on the cover of this unique album cover. Both the critics and the fans hailed it as a masterpiece. Well, like anything good, the Beatles came to an end. That's right. Sgt. Pepper was a high point for the Beatles. And after that, they started having some conflicts and drifting apart. In 1970, the Beatles broke up. Each member of the band created their own solo album. John Lennon became known for his round glasses. He married a Japanese artist named Yoko Ono. They had a son named Sean Lennon, who's about my age. So his name, Sean Lennon, rhymes with his famous dad, John Lennon. And I've seen him on TV. He's very smart. Paul McCartney was in a band called Wings. Wings was not as successful as the Beatles, but how could it be? The Beatles broke all kinds of records. So this shows that Paul McCartney really makes music because it's in his heart and he wants to. He's still rocking and rolling today. Hosts tell us that even during commercial breaks, Paul McCartney will be entertaining the crowd. His concerts go on for 3+ hours. Now, between you and me, students, Paul McCartney probably does not need any more money. He is very wealthy. So in a way, that touches our hearts to prove that he really just enjoys making music, being in front of a crowd. Seems like what he was meant to do. In 1971, George Harrison became the first rock star to organize a major charity concert. Now that happens all the time. If there's a tornado or an earthquake or a pandemic, I think we might be seeing one in our times. That's just when famous musicians raise money as a humanitarian effort to help those who may not be able to help themselves. In 1971, Ringo Starr started a furniture company. Now, I'm not talking traditional furniture. His avant-garde designs included a flower-shaped table with pedal seats, adjustable, of course, and a donut-shaped fireplace. So there was life after the Beatles. they might have had a hard time separating themselves from that identity, because that's what they're famous for, is being a Beatle. So the Beatles changed rock and roll. They're a big part of American culture and can be seen in many places. American Idol has had all Beatles nights. You'll hear the Beatles in movies, TV shows. Oh, just a few years ago, there was a romantic comedy called Yesterday. And the plot of that movie was only one guy could remember that the Beatles existed. That's how much those writers of the movies assume that we know who the Beatles are. John Lennon wrote a successful song called Imagine that was sung earlier this month by some celebrities hoping to raise money. And that's just a little bit about the Beatles, but I'll post some of their songs. I'll miss singing them together, but maybe we could do some more learning about the Beatles together. 1960s.